Good morning and welcome to another edition of the reading of the book of the prophet Jeremiah chapter 38. Then Shephatiah the son of Mattan and Gedaliah the son of Pashur and Jukal the son of Shelemiah and Pashur the son of Malchiah heard the words that Jeremiah had spoken unto all the people, saying, Thus says the Lord, He that remaineth in the city shall die by the sword, the famine, the pestilence, but he that goeth forth to the Chaldeans shall live. For he shall have his life for a prey and shall live. Thus says the Lord, the city shall surely be given into the hand of the king of Babylon's army, which it shall take. Therefore the princes said unto the king, We beseech thee, let this man be put to death. For thus he weakeneth the hands of the men of war that remain in the city, and the hands of all the people in speaking such words unto them. For this man seeketh not the welfare of this people, but the hurt. Then Zedekiah the king said, Behold, he is in your hand. For the king is not he that can do anything against you. Then they took Jeremiah and cast him into the dungeon of Malchiah the son of Hamalek, that was in the court of the prison, and they let down Jeremiah with cords. And in the dungeon there was no water but mire, so Jeremiah sunk into the mire. Now when Ebed-Melech the Ethiopian, one of the eunuchs which was in the king's house, heard that they had put Jeremiah in the dungeon, the king then sitting in the gate of Benjamin, Ebed-Melech went forth out of the king's house and spake unto the king, saying, My lord the king, these men have done evil in all that they have done to Jeremiah the prophet, whom they have cast into the dungeon. And he is like to die for hunger in the place where he is, for there is no more bread in the city. Then the king commanded Ebed-Melech the Ethiopian, saying, Take from hence 30 men with thee, and take up Jeremiah the prophet out of the dungeon before he die. And so Ebed-Melech took men with him, and went into the house of the king under the treasury, and took thence old cast clouts and old rotten rags, and let down them by cords into the dungeon of Jeremiah. And Ebed-Melech the Ethiopian said unto Jeremiah, Put now these old cast clouts and rotten rags under thine armholes under the cords. And Jeremiah did so. And they drew up Jeremiah with cords, and took him out of the dungeon, and Jeremiah remained in the court of the prison. Then Zedekiah the king sent and took Jeremiah the prophet unto him into the third entry that is in the house of the Lord. And the king said unto Jeremiah, I will ask thee a thing, hide nothing from me. And Jeremiah said unto Zedekiah, If I declare it unto thee, wilt thou not surely put me to death? If I give thee counsel, wilt thou not hearken unto me? So Zedekiah the king sows secretly unto Jeremiah, saying, As the Lord liveth that madest this soul, I will not put thee to death. Neither will I give thee into the hand of these men that seek thy life. Then said Jeremiah unto Zedekiah, Thus saith the Lord God of hosts, the God of Israel, if thou wilt assuredly go forth unto the king of Babylon's princes, then thy soul shall live, and its city shall not be burnt with fire, and thou shalt live and thy house. But if thou not go forth to the king of Babylon's princes, then shall the city be given into the hand of the Chaldeans, and they shall burn it with fire, and thou shalt not escape out of their hand. And Zedekiah the king said unto Jeremiah, saying, I am afraid of the Jews that have fallen unto the Chaldeans, lest they deliver me into their hand, and they mock me. But Jeremiah said, They shall not deliver thee. Obey, I beseech thee, the voice of the Lord, which I speak unto thee. So it shall be well unto thee, and thy soul shall live. But if thou refuse to go forth, this is the word of the Lord that he has shown me. Behold, all the women that are left in the king of Judah's house shall be brought forth to the king of Babylon's princes. And those women shall say, Thy friends have set thee on and prevailed against thee. Thy feet are sunk in the mire, and they are turned away back. So they shall bring out all thy wives and thy children to the Chaldeans. And thou shalt not escape out of their hand, but shall be taken by the hand of the king of Babylon. And thou shalt cause this city to be burnt with fire. Then said Zedekiah unto Jeremiah, Let no man know of these words, and thou shalt not die. But if princes hear that I have talked with thee, and they come unto me and say unto thee, Declare with unto us what thou hast said unto the king, hide it not from us, and we will not put thee to death. Also what the king said unto thee, then shalt thou say unto them, I presented my supplication before the king, that he would not cause me to return to Jonathan's house to die there. Then came all the princes unto Jeremiah and asked him, and he told them according to all the words that the king had commanded. So they left off speaking with him, for the matter was not pursued. And so Jeremiah abode in the court of the prison until the day that the Jerusalem was taken, and he was there when Jerusalem was taken. Chapter 39. In the 9th year of Zedekiah, king of Judah, in the 10th month, came Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, and all his army against Jerusalem, and they besieged it. And in the 11th year of Zedekiah, in the 4th month, the 9th day of the month, the city was broken up. And all the princes of the king of Babylon came in and sat in the middle gate, even Nergal-Shareser, Samgar-Nebo, Sarshesim, Rabsaris, Nergal-Shareser, Rabmag, with all the residue of the princes of the king of Babylon. And it came to pass that when Zedekiah the king of Judah saw them, and all men of the war, that they had fled, and went forth out of the city by night, by the way of the king's garden, by the gate between the two walls, and he went out the way of the plain. But the Chaldeans' army pursued after them, and overtook Zedekiah in the plains of Jericho. And when they had taken him, they brought him to Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, to Riblah in the land of Hamath, where he gave judgment upon him. And the king of Babylon slew the sons of Zedekiah in Riblah before his eyes. Also the king of Babylon slew all the nobles of Judah. Moreover, he put out Zedekiah's eyes and bound him with chains to carry him into Babylon. And the Chaldeans burned the king's house and the houses of the people with fire and broke down the walls of Jerusalem. Then Nebuchadnezzar, the captain of the guard, carried away captive into Babylon the remnant of the people that remained in the city. And those that fell away, that fell to him, with the rest of the people remained. And Nebuzaradan, the captain of the guard, left of the poor of the people which had nothing in the land of Judah, and gave them vineyards and fields at the same time. Now Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, gave charge concerning Jeremiah to Nebuzaradan, the captain of the guard, saying, Take him and look well unto him, and do him no harm, but do unto him even as he shall say unto thee. So Nebuzaradan, the captain of the guard, sent, and Nebushashban, Rabsaris, and Nergal-Shareser, Rabmag, and all the king of Babylon's princes, even they sent and took Jeremiah out of the court of the prison, and committed him unto Gedaliah, the son of Ahikam, the son of Shaphan, that he should carry him home. So he dwelt among the people. And the word of the Lord came unto Jeremiah while he was shut in the court of the prison, saying, Go and speak to Ebed-Melech the Ethiopian, saying, Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, Behold, I will bring my words upon this city for evil and not for good, and they shall be accomplished in the day before thee. But I will deliver thee in that day, says the Lord, and thou shalt not be given into the hand of the men of whom thou art afraid. For I will surely deliver thee, and thou shalt not fall by the sword, but thy life shall be for a prey unto thee, because thou hast put thy trust in me, says the Lord.